This is the reading to learn math page for section 9.3 on similar triangles. We're going to determine whether each statement is always, sometimes, or never true. If it's not always true, explain why. If two angles of one triangle are congruent to two angles of another triangle, then the triangles are similar. That's always. What they just told you was the angle-angle shortcut. Part B. If the measures of two sides of one triangle are proportional to the measures of corresponding sides of another triangle, then the triangles are similar. Well, the way it's stated, that's not enough to say that they definitely are similar, but they certainly could be, which is why we're going to put sometimes. If you had congruent angles in between those proportional sides, then they would be similar. That would be side angle side. Part C says, if two angles of one triangle are congruent to two angles of another triangle, then the third angles are also congruent. That's always. That's your third angles theorem. Part D, if two triangles are both right triangles, then they are similar. That's not enough information to say that they definitely are. You can have two right triangles that are similar, and you can have two right triangles that are not similar. So we're going to put sometimes on this. Now, if you had two right triangles with a pair of congruent acute angles, then they would be similar, because that would be angle-angle. Part E, if the measures of three sides of one triangle are proportional to the measures of the corresponding sides of another triangle, then the triangles are congruent. Well, they're definitely similar. Does it mean that they're congruent? Not necessarily. They'll be congruent if the scale factor or similarity ratio is 1:1. So we're going to put sometimes on here because of that. If you wanted to switch this to a true statement, just cross out congruent and put similar. That would make them similar. That's side, 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 three pairs of proportional sides. Number two, determine whether the triangles are similar. Explain the method that you use. If the triangles are similar, write a similarity statement using the correct order of the vertices of the triangles. Okay, so if this triangle is going to be similar to this triangle, then the smallest side is going to have to correspond with the smallest side. That's just the way that it works. This triangle is isosceles, so we have two sides of length 12, and that matches up with this guy, obviously, two sides of 16. So if these ratios all equal the same thing, then what that means is you got three pairs of proportional sides. And if you have that, then the triangles are similar. So let's check. What is 6/8 reduced? It's 3/4. How about 12/16? It's 3/4 as well. So these are all the same. They're 3/4. So they are similar by side, side, side. You need to name the triangles now. I'll call this, I'll start at the vertex angle since this is an isosceles triangle, ABC. And it's similar to this triangle. I'll start at the vertex angle. Now, it doesn't matter which base angle I go to. So we have some freedom here since it's isosceles. We'll call it SZM.